See, I think we can now move to our final presentation of the day by Ruxandra Alina Vodă on algorithmic decision making and challenges for leaders.
Hello, everybody. Let me see if you tell me if you see my screen.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I can see you at the moment.
Close share tray, open share tray. Now let me do like this.
We did manage to do it earlier.
Yeah, we did.
So it's that little box with an arrow, upward arrow. So if you hover over the screen, you will see the menu, and then there will be next to the icon of microphone, there will be kind of like a square box with an arrow pointing upwards. Oh, there you go.
Yes, it was open and it couldn't see it.
Oh, great.
Hello, everybody. I am a doctoral student with the Tiffin University, United States. This presentation is the result of research congruent to my doctoral dissertation. I have done it in a collaboration with Dr. Perry Han, who was my lecturer, my instructor in the specific course. This presentation is actually related to leadership and algorithmic decision making. And when I say algorithmic decision making, I am referring to any type of algorithmic support we use, starting from the regular recommender systems or from robotic process automation in the organizations that automate certain tasks performed by humans or more complex artificial intelligence based platforms, for example, helping medical staff diagnosing or taking a treatment decision. So I am referring it in a general manner. And why I consider this topic is actual, because as digitalization continues its path and its development, and organizations and companies have enrolled in a global race to exploit its advantages, leaders have progressively incorporated algorithmic decision-making in their own decision-making process and in the organizational decision-making process. So, for example, Boston Consulting Group study in 2018 showed that on several big countries showed that 85% of Chinese companies and between 40 and 50% of the organizations in the rest of the nations have become active players in piloting or adopting or successfully exploiting algorithms to grow their businesses. And even countries at administrative level have launched nationwide programs to support artificial intelligence incorporation in daily lives, such as the National Artificial Intelligence Initiative in the United States, which was launched January this year. So leaders are increasingly relying and using algorithmic decision making in their decision making every day. And this topic and perspectives are actual, even more that now we are the concept of algorithmic manager or automation of leadership are emerging. And this comes with a series of challenges for leaders, and this paper showcases the challenges the leaders are facing in incorporating algorithmic decision making and some ways to overpass them. First of all, Let's look a bit in the area of digitalization and leadership. So we all know that leaders are critical factors for digital culture development. Why? Because they relate with multiple and scattered stakeholders. They have to create collaborative processes in complex settings, and in the same time, they manage ethical concerns. And leaders have to make high-speed decisions in an ambiguous environment and in an informationally overloaded environment. And they can use artificial intelligence for decision-making in several ways. So they can use it as an expert system, as a system to provide, let's say, expert information. They can use it as a cognitive process automation, such as I said, robotic process automation. They can use it as providing cognitive insights, or they can use artificial intelligence to provide cognitive enhancements. A study of Kedding this year, a very recent study, he looked at the digitalization and the digital algorithmic decision making from two perspectives, condition oriented, like exploring antecedents, how to use AI in strategic management, and outcome oriented, meaning the consequences of AI in strategic management. He notes that when we look at artificial intelligence and digitalization and implementing artificial intelligence in organization, this is not an instantly embedded technology with fast returns. It takes a lot of time, and it takes a lot of effort, and it takes a lot of investments. Also, AI implementation attracts, when you implement artificial intelligence in the systems and AI algorithmic decision making in organization, you have to attract a high level of trustworthiness and acceptance from the followers. Also, it shows that AI-based systems can either support human managers or replace them in routine tasks. At the same time, artificial intelligence and algorithmic decision-making systems support managers deal with this information overload leaders are currently facing. He also notes, and you will see as a red line in the presentation, that this is not implementing AI, but it's rather a human-machine strategic partnership. Because artificial intelligence and using algorithmic decision-making support can leverage, can bring a lot of advantages in strategic decision-making. So I have talked a little bit why it's needed, how artificial intelligence is incorporated in organization, and now let's look at strategic and organizational decision-making models. I put a quote there: in the future, humans and artificial intelligence could strengthen organizational decision-making processes reciprocally. We will see this collaboration further on. So humans and artificial intelligence could strengthen organizational decision-making process reciprocally, because humans have the advantage of intuitive decision-making. Artificial intelligence has the advantage in addressing complexities in decision-making. And lastly, human decision-makers hold the responsibility in the decision and handling all the decision universe. So therefore, humans and AI can collaborate in two ways: handle different aspects of decision making. AI can handle the complexity, humans can focus on uncertainty, and even more in a complex situation where AI has an advantage, and therefore a combined role in decision making would provide an advantage in complex and uncertain situations. There is another study that brings in front modalities of strategic and decision making in organizations. Srestab and Mahman and von Kroch propose a new framework of combined human decision making and artificial decision making. It included full human to AI delegation or hybrid human to AI and then AI to human sequential decision making, and then aggregating the human AI decision making. You also see here some examples, full human to AI delegation. You see them in the daily life as well, are the recommended system, traffic planning, dynamic pricing, or systems that detect fraud. Hybrid decision making can be used in healthcare monitoring, in hiring and loan application assessment, or when human decision making is an input for artificial decision making, is also used in sports strategy or in health and monitoring. Now, this is one of the models. But leaders do not decide by themselves. So decision making in organization is not necessarily an individual decision making. We talk about group decision making, or how Ding et al. Are saying is a large scale decision making. Large scale decision making means when an organization and leaders make a decision, but they have to incorporate the input of multiple stakeholders, such as, for example, when an organization decides the environment strategy or the corporate responsibility approach. They deal with multiple stakeholders and they have to reach consensus and agreement and get all the input. And in such complex context with multiple stakeholders, algorithmic decision making can support leaders to gather data and understand motivation and attitudes, supporting consensus building, provide monitoring tools, check the security and integrity of such big, large-scale decision making, or gather all the multiple approaches towards a decision, and are providing aggregated information. So in supporting strategic organizational decision making, the most considerable challenge would be that humans ensure the necessity of quantity and quality of input data, and AI can deal with such data and provide the best recommendation. So in such context, leaders have to be proactive. Leaders have to be proactive. It's a different type of proactivity because they are responsible for algorithmic decision making in an organization. They have to change strategies, processes, and organizational cultures to embrace the change. Also, leaders, as we have seen before, have multiple choice to integrate algorithmic decision making in organization, either as support of human decision making, as hybrid, or to enhance human decision making. Leaders can also start to implement this disruptively or incrementally. Literature shows that an incremental approach is the most feasible approach in our context. Synthesizing relevant literature from on this topic, I have made a summary of the challenges of leaders. And as we can see here, these challenges start from the individual level. There are organizational related challenges and there are external related challenges. So in managing all these challenges, leaders must change their leadership style, approach decision making differently, and guiding the followers in leveraging the advantages of artificial intelligence in a novel manner. How they can do it? Besides adapting their leadership style and behavior, they have to improve skills and competencies, such as foresight or large-scale decision-making capabilities. They can address the organization preparedness, change the organization strategy to accelerate AI adoption, and adjust the organization structure and processes to maximize benefits. Also, they have an important mission to bring all the teams on board, and no matter the geography or level of understanding, and explore together the potential of artificial intelligence application in business. Of course, by doing that, they have to change their human resources management strategies, like in recruitment and training. They have to ensure the most appropriate mix of competencies and skills. For example, you need people to hold expertise in data science, in engineering, in software engineering, or in business development and sales using artificial intelligence support. At the same time, with improving visioning and foresight capabilities, leaders would be able to anticipate better the industry evolution, the competition transformation, the gaps on the market and in the organization, and the potential development in regulation. So this presentation is just a snapshot of the challenges of leader in adopting algorithmic decision making in organization. It does not approach the legal aspects. Nevertheless, there is to underline one important thing. In both immediate and medium future, with on the measure AI embeds in leadership and organizational decision making, leaders have to be ever more aware of the ethical and legal aspects of including algorithmic decision making. And also, we are seeing that the regulatory frames are changing gradually to accommodate such evolution. So all this being said, thank you. I will do stop share, so that I can take the Q&A. I hope I share.
Yes, thank you, Ruxandra. I have to praise all our speakers because they were so on time. I have never seen anything like it before, so organized. Thank you for that wonderful presentation so much to take in, especially because you're talking about something that now emerges as a new industrial landscape, and we don't know much about it. So forgive me if I'm going to veer into obvious, but I was just wondering if you could kind of expand on this idea that of agentic machines, that we have these machines that are that have agency to make decisions, to help leaders in mm-hmm. their practice. So, if you could tell us a bit more about that kind of agentic property of the machines, how do you see that kind of, do you see it as agentic or do you see it as something else?
I work well with examples. I will just give an example. For example, brokers. Let's say imagine brokers on Wall Street. When they take decisions to recommend an investment or purchase of shares, they use such kind of algorithmic decision-making supports. So these are the type of software with machine learning embedded that use the information and provide you with a recommendation, invest here or invest there. it's known that up to certain decision, the brokers do not check. So they just give the agency to the machine. From their experience also, and from the previous machine recommendation, they know the recommendation is okay. They just take it and recommend the investors go for this option purchase or sell or buy or hold. Okay, so just in this scenario, the machine has different types of agency. When it's, let's say, regular business, you give full delegation to algorithmic decision making. Okay, when there is a controversial case, for example, you have to buy or sell in a company that has recently been in the headlines. Now there goes the human judgment into it. Mm. So you don't give the full agency to the machine. And here is the challenges for leaders. When do you give full agency? And when your intuition, knowledge, human part intervenes in correcting or corroborating the recommendation from the machine. I hope I answered.
Yes, you have. I'm also wondering, you know, if leaders are those who are basing their decisions on the recommendations of the algorithm, how do we then refer to those who create these algorithms? Because obviously these algorithms are not neutral, are not politically neutral, and they, whoever builds them, build into them all these kind of preconceptions about, well, right and wrong, and, you know, or certain ideology. We have now algorithmic decision making present in courts, which can be very problematic, mm-hmm. And not only in the example that you listed, we have them, acting as employers, like having the power. We heard today from Jamie Woodcock about algorithms having power to hire or fire people, or stop your contract without explaining it to you. So how do we then reconcile leadership with that kind of behind story about builders of algorithmic management? Sorry, algorithm.
A very good question. So I will just split it into parts. Related to the first part, there is a study in 2018, Smith and Green, and it's connected to the first part of your question. What about those who program? So leaders and those who program. In a possible future, leaders will focus more on in managing the AI machines and programmers. So leaders would have to focus a lot in managing AI programmers, communicating with them, influencing them, and basically returning from transformational leadership to a more, traditional management, where traditional management means teaching the AI programmers about leadership, about ethical standards, about moral, doing moral mentoring. So more and more, we have to incorporate these traditional parts of leadership in the future leadership, because leaders will have to combine managing the machines and the ones who program the machine. And speaking about the second part of your questions, there is a huge debate nowadays of fairness of algorithmic decision making. And it's exactly referring to the types of examples you mentioned, like hiring or basically deciding in court. For example, in the United States, a lot of the court decisions are based on algorithmic decision making. And there is this debate how you ensure that the machines are ethical, because basically, and they are fair, because basically there is the risk of perpetuating the programmer's biases into the algorithm biases. And there are a lot of debates and also regulations on this area and multiple control points, so that you ensure that such machines do not perpetuate the biases of the ones who program them.
Thank you very much for that thoughtful answer, albeit very scary answer. I see that Victor Perez has raised his hand. Victor, do you want to pose a question?
Hi, yes. Thank you for your presentation. It was very interesting. And in my own research, I'm examining how leadership emerges within bodily encounters between humans and non-humans. And in my field work in a design / software development company, I experienced a little event in which they were talking about the accessibility reports. So they were using a software called Silktight, which helps developers to know a score. And with that score, they know whether the website is accessible or not for wider audiences with certain disabilities or special requirements. And in that process, some of the developers started to react against the software, in which they used to say, we have to be mindful about the algorithm because the algorithm wants to be fed, and we have to be mindful about this. So my question is about the spaces for resistance when you have an algorithm telling you what to do. Have you thought about power and resistance relations in that,
yes,
that sense?
That's a very good question, and it's exactly on my, let's say, topic. There are actually two big trends. The two big trends in research are called algorithm aversion, that was coined by Ditvorst and others in 2015, and nowadays algorithm appreciation, that was coined by Log and others in 2019. You are referring to algorithm aversion. It's basically when you as a person would rather rely on human advice than on algorithmic advice, especially after you see the machine err. Okay? And one way to face this resistance in research is explainability of AI. So basically, if you want that your people should not comment on what the algorithm is doing and why it recommends this, you as a leader should be able to explain the mechanics, how the AI was programmed. Otherwise, you will go with aversion. And also related to the previous presentation we had, COVID, a lot of algorithms were deciding and recommending patients triage, I don't know how to say it in English, selecting on who is more emergency than other emergency. And we have seen that in this situation, in high-risk situations, people would rather rely on human intuition advice. So in high-risk situation, people seek human leadership. So yes, we are dealing with algorithm aversion, as you said. It's well-researched, it has a lot of root causes, and also there are some measures how to overcome algorithm aversion. One of them is explainability, making the machine programming transparent to the user. This is how the machine decided to recruit me, okay, or to fire me. Oh dear.
Thank you very much, both of you. Thank you to our wonderful presenters, Leo, Simon, Tracy, and Ruxandra.